You are taken advantage of by others. And you find Africans are totally absent. That's how we get this problem now. We have the one of shortage of vaccines in the whole of Africa. Our people are working on another type of vaccine in the virus center. And as Magora was saying, one of the things they were looking for to start was the green monkey killing the cells. That the African green monkey, this is the African green monkey. Apparently it has got cells somewhere, I don't know, the kidney or some place, which cells can grow where the virus is. If you have got those cells, you can easily grow these viruses like this one of corona. They like, I don't know why they like those cells. And my people were looking for these cells in the whole of Africa. They were nowhere. The whole of Africa. South Africa, Morocco, nothing. Egypt. So they had to go to some other place. And remember, these are cells of the African green monkey. So somebody took these cells, and some other people, not only one, many took, and multiplied them. But nobody in Africa had these cells until now. We have them now. And apparently this is the first time these cells of the African green monkey are being used in a laboratory in Africa to multiply the viruses, all these viruses, the different types. So this shows you the word Magora knows very well, Kulambala. This is Kulala, Africa Merala son. So the operation we are talking about, Operation Earth Creation, ni itihali ya kuamusha.
You mad, you are asleep, why don't you do this?
Then from home to home we are working people. That's what we are doing. That's why we have this phenomenon of what they call subsistence agriculture. Chirimo cha tumbo peke yake. This is the problem of Uganda. There is no other problem. Chirimo cha tumbo peke yake, what they call subsistence agriculture, or subsistence activities, we are accounting for 68% of the homesteads in 2013. I had seen this in the census of 1991. I saw that figure, 68% of the homesteads. They are in the non-money economy, what they call subsistence sector. That was the census of 1991. Then the other census which followed was, 2001. The same figure, it was not changing. So when it came 2013, I said, no. That's why I involved the army now, to wake up these people, to use their land to produce both for the stomach, but also for the pocket. And we do so with what we call a kibaro, in our language, what we mean a sabu. Kirimo cha tumbo na mfukoni mkitumia hesabu. Because when you grow maize in 1 acre, you may not earn the same like when you grow coffee. You find that one is higher than the other. So, ukiwa na ardhi kidogo, ekazi mbili, ekazi tatu, inafaa uchague shughuli gani. Enterprise selection. This is really thinking for our villagers who cannot think, who cannot wachambulia, kwa sababu hawezi kuchambulia mwenyewe. Wachambulia, tufanye nini? So now, in the recent survey of the household survey, for the first time now, they are saying 61% of the homesteads are now in the non-economy. Wale watumia tuko peke yake, wamebaki 39%. Of course, it's still a big number, but it's better than where we were. So I'm very happy that now on the issue of the biodiversity, the revolution is now taking place. Don't remember, you are visitors from where we come from, America, wherever. All the human beings started here in East Africa. Even you people, you are former Africans. But when you went to Europe, you lost the color. But all human beings started here. 4.5 million years ago. And there's a reason why the human beings started here. Why didn't human beings develop first in Europe or anywhere? It was here, and not only here, but in East Africa. And it was only 100,000 years ago that the first people left Africa to go to other parts of the world. So that means there are some specific things here which don't exist anywhere else. And one of them, because here you have the forest, a huge Congo forest, like the one of the Amazon, and the ones in Southeast Asia, like the forests in Indonesia, Malaysia, Burma. But the forest here is huge, the forest of Congo, partly in Uganda, and then the one in the Amazon in South America. So this East Africa is on the boundary between the forest and the mountains of Ethiopia. And it is on a high plateau. So there are things here which don't exist anywhere else. That's why the human beings imagined here. Because it was grassland, neighboring forest, and neighboring the highlands. So in terms of biodiversity, it is unrivaled. So there is now a new revolution, where the children of the indigenous people, of the traditional people, like me, I am a son of a cattle keeper, traditional cattle keeper. Even Ruto must be like that. So, where I come from, my knowledge, we have a lot of traditional knowledge. When I come to modern knowledge, then I can look back. What were we taught what were you doing in the crowd? You are doing this, you are doing that, you are doing that, you are using this medicine, you are using that medicine.
Now the business community. I'm so glad Your Excellency the Deputy President of the Republic of Kenya. I'm so happy to have you coming.